have everybody in God's house today. Well, you'll notice the pastor's not here today. And
we just want to invite the presence of the Lord in today. And others are coming in. And they always surprise me here. And but we'll have a good time in God. Amen. Amen. All righty. I'm just checking to see if he's awake. But I'm glad. I've been up for a little while. But this is a great day. Sunday's a day we set aside where we can worship him. And it's a day when we come and we come to worship him in spirit and truth. And I hope you didn't come for me today. And but I came today to fellowship with my Lord and Savior. Yeah, he sits at the right hand of the Father, but I can fellowship with him today. And so we're glad you're here. And let's just stand to our feet this morning, and we're gonna invite the Lord into this house today. Father, we love you today. We thank you, Lord, for who you are. And Lord, you're an awesome God. Lord, it's in you that we live and move and have our very being, God. So today, we, Lord, we know your spirit goes with us wherever we go. But God, Lord, as we join together here corporately today, Lord, you just have your way in this service, God. You lead us and you guide us. You direct us, Lord. And we'll forever praise you and lift you up and give you all the glory and all the praise and all the honor. You are worthy of it all. In Jesus' name. Amen. And I want to share just later on we're going to pray and over these requests. And but I just want to make a mention of them this morning, and then we're going to pray later on in the service for these requests. Remember Pastor Mark and Holly in Wisconsin, I believe, Milwaukee, and how many believe pastor needs a rest every now and then and a break? Amen. Well, if you've never been a pastor, they do, because they're just like all the rest of us. They need a time away. So pray for Mark and Holly. We want to continue to pray for Alice's granddaughter, Jacqueline. And I didn't get to touch base with her, but pray for Jacqueline. That's Gloria and Johnny's daughter. And we want to continue to pray for Ron and Linda's friends of their family, Brent and Letitia, if I'm saying it right. And pray for them. They're in Turkey, had an accident, and they need a miracle. They just definitely need a miracle. And Saturday morning, I'd been up for a while, and when I first saw her, I'd been upstairs in different places. And when I first saw her, she said, we got bad news this morning. And she went on to tell me about an accident, some folks we know. If you follow any Southern gospel music, you know the Rex Neeland singers years ago, and the daughter carried that tradition on, and they called themselves the Neeland singers. They were involved in a plane crash happened over Wyoming, and they were all killed. Was a mom and dad, Kelly and Jason, and their daughter Autumn and Jamie Streetman, the pilot Larry Haney and his wife, and also their assistant. Seven people died in that crash, and they were on their way for a Bill Gaither tour cruise that was going to leave from Seattle. I may not have all the details right, but it was heavy news for us, because you know we've played alongside the group, and they've been in Marty and Marty's parents' home, and it's just been a heavy kind of weekend. But you know, God knows. I said God knows. And God's got you. He's got the Neeland family. He's got the Haney family and the Streetman family. He's got them all. And there's one daughter, surviving daughter, and she also sung in the group, and she's got an uncle named Todd, and I've known him for a lot of years, but they need our prayer. And we're gonna pray over them later, but I want to say a quick prayer for those families right now. Father, Lord, you know hearts are heavy all across America today for these singers, God. But a lot of these needs are local. They're right here with us, but they're all needs. And Lord, you said when the body of Christ hurts, we all hurt. And when we all rejoice, we should all rejoice. So God, help us today, God. Lean upon you and trust you. And Lord, just minister to hearts and families today, God. Heartbroken, God. Lord, you know what it is to have a broken heart. Your heart must have been broken, Lord, when your son had to come to this earth. Lord, so we just ask you today to have your way in this service. Lord, as we worship you, Lord, in song, God, as we praise you, Lord, as we bring our offerings, God. Lord, I just pray, God, that we would take a time to give before you, Lord, and set aside all the things of the world, God. And Lord, you would just have your way in each and every one that's in this congregation today. And if you agree with that, just say amen. Amen. Well, stand with me this morning. You are standing, most of you, and we're going to sing today. I love this old song. We sing it around here. It just simply says, they that wait upon the Lord. You know, sometimes to hear from God, you just have to wait on the Lord. So sing it with us. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not be faint. I can't hear you. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Teach me, Lord, to wait. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Teach me, Lord, the way. Amen. Well, now y'all got me a little bit worried this morning. Now, I'm sorry if you smelt a skunk when you come in the door. It wasn't me. And I figure that's why all of you in the back, amen. But when I came in this morning and unlocked the church, there was a real strong odor, and I think maybe one camped out on the front porch. And but I never did see him. I thought maybe I would. It was so strong. But anyway, you know, a skunk is a skunk. And you know a skunk by the way they look. You know, they're black. Most of them I ever seen had a white stripe, amen. And but even if you don't see them, right, yeah, you can smell them. Amen. But now, I need some banner waivers this morning. Come on, find me some banner waivers. Come on, y'all don't be bashful. All right. Come on, here we go. Sing a little bit more. We're going to do it again. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Teach me, Lord. Teach me, Lord. Put your hands together. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Teach me, Lord, to wait. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be
weary today shall walk in comfort. Teach me, Lord, teach me, Lord, to wait. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Teach the Lord to wait.
They that wait upon the Lord
shall renew their strength. They shall mount.
Teach me, Lord,
teach me, Lord, to obey. Last line. Teach me, Lord,
teach me, Lord, to obey. Amen. We want to sing a few out of the hymn book this morning. And I love this old song. It says, my favorite verse is, it says, what have I to dread? What have I to fear? Leaning on the everlasting arms, I have blessed peace with my Lord so near, leaning on the everlasting arms. Praise God. I want you to sing it with me this morning, and we'll have a good time in the Lord. We got everybody warmed up now. Look over at your neighbor and say, you're all warmed up. All right. Praise God. Well, you know what? Sometimes it's just like that. I had an old Chevrolet, but the only way you could get it warmed up, you had to choke it about halfway to town. And but by the time you got there, you had to remember to turn that choke off because it used too much gas. But amen. That's old days. Now we got electric cars. I don't know what we're going to do with all that. But anyway, amen. All right, young people, help me with this.
Leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms.
What a fellowship!
What a fellowship! What a joy divine! Leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Leaning on Jesus, leaning on Jesus, safe and secure from all alarms.
Leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Oh, how sweet to walk in this pilgrim way,
leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how bright the path grows from day to day, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Sing it out.
Leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms.
Sing it a cappella.
Leaning on Jesus, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning on Jesus, leaning on Jesus, leaning on the everlasting arms.
What have I to dread? What have I to fear?
Leaning on the everlasting arms. I have blessed me with my Lord so near, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Leaning on Jesus,
leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning, Jesus, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Last line.
Leaning on the everlasting arms.
Give the Lord a hand clap. He's worthy. He's so worthy of our praise. Amen. We love him today. I hope you do. I hope you know him as Lord and Savior. Before you leave today, I want you to know him as your Lord and Savior. I found him to be the best thing that ever happened to this old boy. But amen. We're glad you're here. And maybe we haven't saw you, but boy, I tell you, it's good to see you today. And we're just going to keep on moving right here. Try this little song. And me and brother, we're a little short-handed today. And we miss Leon and Ed and some others that are away. But you know what? Church don't stop. Amen. I miss my pastor, but church don't stop. Amen. So I got to just keep on going. But we're going to do this one. And me and brother, we have a tendency to get things too fast. Three chords and a cloud of dust. But today we're going to try to do this one. And I was really saying it to me, but I said we need to try to keep this in slow so we can keep control. But now, if y'all want to run, shout, wherever you want to do, you just help yourself. If you want to sit there in your seat and just worship the Lord and weep, true worshipers worship the way that they can touch God. Amen. So sing this one today. It says, amen. Jesus is the way maker.
The way maker, Jesus is the way maker. Jesus is the way maker. One day he made a way for me when my life was dark and drear. Jesus heard and he answered my prayer. One day he made a way for me.
Jesus. He is the way maker. Faces, good to have you here today. Amen. Sing this one today. And, I love this one. It's an old hymn. But it says, simply says, Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. Amen. Comes out of the hymn book on page 391. Sing it with me this morning. Sing the chorus. Jesus, Jesus,
how I trust, how I prove him more and Lord Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. Oh, for grace to trust Him more.
Sing that again.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more.
Sing it a cappella.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more.
Sing that first verse.
'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take Him at His word, just to rest upon His promise, just to know the same the
sing it out.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. Trust in Jesus, just to trust His cleansing blood, just in sinful faith to plunge me with the healing cleansing blood. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I've proved Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more. Oh, for grace to trust Him more.
Sing that fourth verse. Fourth verse, I'm so glad.
I'm so glad I've learned to trust Thee, precious Jesus, Savior, friend. And I know that Thou art with me, will be with me till the Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more.
One more time, a cappella, sing the chorus.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust Him, how I prove Him o'er and o'er. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus, oh, for grace to trust Him more.
Oh, for grace.
Oh, for grace. to trust Him more.
Amen. I want you to do something for me today. Come on, just keep an attitude of worship and prayer. And we're going to have a good time in God's house today. I know many of your hearts are heavy. Mine is. But you know what? I know a God. I know a God. I know the man. Amen. And He's always been my help. He's always your help. Now I want to do something a little bit different. Instead of turning you loose and let you go all over church, I just want you to turn around and look at all those people behind you and wave. Just wave at them. Just turn around. Come on, don't be bashful. Just turn around. They're going to wave at you. All right, now look up front. Amen. Just worship. Come on, just fellowship together. Amen. Sing that one more time.
Jesus, Jesus, how I trust You. How I prove Him more and more. Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. Oh, for grace to trust Him more. Oh, for grace to trust Him more.
People love this one on Wednesday night. We haven't sung it on Wednesday night, but I think they know it all by heart, and they could come and lead it today, and we appreciate them. And we got some other announcements, but just keep our mind on the Lord. This one says, You are here moving in our midst. How many believe He's here today?
Yeah.
Amen. He's everywhere. Amen.
Waymaker, miracle is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are.
That is who you are. Even when.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel that you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working. Even when I don't see that you're working. Even when I don't feel that you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working.
Glad you're here today, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on, let's worship corporately. You know, we don't always get to do this. Amen. Sometimes I'm just in my truck or out in the backyard, but when I get together with believers, amen, that's a good time to worship the Lord. All times are good to worship the Lord. Maybe God enjoys my presence more when I'm still. And maybe I get more out of it than when I'm still. Amen. We're glad you're here today. I'm going to sing one more. You can be seated if you'd like. If you want to sing this one, you can stand. Just however you feel comfortable today. Amen. I tell Marty every now and then, I'll use a word. I did it yesterday, and I said something about something being awesome. I don't know if I was looking at a truck or... But there's certain words I want to try to say for God. And He's awesome. And He deserves all the praise. He deserves my best. He deserves all my best words. Amen. When I worship Him... That's a lot of different ways. It's not just giving money. It's not just singing a song, but it's my life. How am I worshiping? How am I doing? Do I get still or do I just take him my list? A lot of times, I don't know if you feel like I do, but sometimes I just feel like I take him all of my big list and I dump it and I run off. Amen. How would that work with your wife? Not too good. Or how would that work with your husband? Not too good. You see, it takes relationship. He said, depart from me because I never, what, knew you. God desires to have a relationship with you, to know you. Now, men and women are different, but I'm going to tell you what. Whew, amen. I thank God for, a long time, 34 years knowing that young lady back there, and 22 years living under the same roof in Dayton, or you, I know you're going to pass out for 12 years, but you know what? I still don't know her the way I need to know her. And if I can say that about my wife, how can I not say that about my Lord? He's deep. And he has all the answers. He's my help. He's my friend. And today I can call him awesome. I can call him awesome. You can call him awesome today if you know him. If you don't, you need to know him. We're living in a day where you need to know the Lord. I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're young or old. Don't believe a lie that one day you'll get things straightened out. Come on, just get them straightened out right now and be ready to meet God if he wants to call you home. You don't know. We don't know. Our friends got on the airplane headed for Seattle thinking they would arrive there and do something they do every year. Get on a boat and listen to Southern gospel music and sing and fellowship and eat. And then one day, when the week's over, come back. See Alaska. But it didn't happen that way. But you know they're all right. You know why? Because I know a place that the Bible tells me is better than Alaska.
Right.
Amen. Amen. And sometimes we fret and fear over this. Let's don't fear dying. Amen. Let's just know God. Let's have a respectful fear of God and be ready to meet him. If you don't know him, come on. I cry out to you today to know him before you walk out those doors. Amen. And just be open to it. Just be open to him. He loves you today. I believe God speaks to you. Now, don't go tell your doctor that, because he'll tell you you need some pills. And don't tell him that in the emergency room, because they'll take you up on the sixth floor. Or they'll call a security guard. But I'm not ashamed of my Jesus today. You know why? Because he loved me when nobody else loved me. He loved you. And we're going to share a scripture in a few minutes that kind of backs that up. You see, what I can tell you, it don't mean nothing unless it's backed up by the word of God today. Amen. Sing this little chorus that says, you are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God.
Cry it out, church.
You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in God. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in God.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
I just want to open up the. Now, the position of our bodies is not important. Amen. But I want to open up this altar, because we still have an altar and we still come around here and we worship and we praise the Lord together. And now, if you don't want to come, that's all right. And I don't think it'll offend God if you don't come or you don't. It won't offend me if you do come or you don't come. But, boy, I tell you, sometimes it's just good just to honor him. And I'm going to give you opportunity to that. I'm just going to sing that one more time through, I believe. And if you feel comfortable too, or you don't, I want you to just come and come around this altar and just sing it. Maybe we'll sing it once or twice more.
You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place. I'm a part of you. You are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God.
Amen. Come on, just give him a wave off. He's good. He's good. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Lord, we're glad we're gathered in this place. Lord, in this church, Lord, today, God. So, Lord, you take complete control, God, as we don't let us get ahead of you today, Lord Jesus. Come on. Let's sing one more time, a cappella. I won't sing it no more.
You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God.
Let's do it one more time.
You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You're worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, Lord. The Lord is good. The Lord is good. Amen. We're worshiping together in spirit and truth. Amen. You say, Pastor Kenny, you're not in any hurry. No, I'm not. Because I run up and down the road every week, wide open. I run to a job. Amen. I run to take care of my stuff and all this stuff. And take care of church stuff. Church stuff ain't always God's stuff. Amen. And I'm just trying to find some more balance in my life. Correct balance. Amen. With my Lord and my Savior first. Amen. God first. And if you've been running the wrong way, it's pretty hard to get back on course because you kind of get a rut cut in the ground. But God wants us to live a certain way. You see, I can know all of the scriptures. I can quote them from cover to cover. And but it's when I live them is when it really changes me. And it's when God notices me. And I need him to notice me. Why? Because I want to get to heaven one day.
Amen.
I want to trust him. If this life is all we get, folks, it ain't much. But I believe there's eternal life for the child of God. I believe we have hope. Amen. And if we leave this life, what we think is too soon. Amen. Paul said to be absent from the body was to be present with the Lord. And amen. Don't you worry about it. Amen. If you know God, if you're ready to meet him. If you're not, then you need to be ready. Amen. And I feel like the Lord's called me to help Pastor Mark here, and I appreciate my pastor. And I hope you pray for your pastor every week. Amen, because he needs it, you know, because he don't just have his stuff. He's got yours and yours and yours and yours and all that stuff. But what the Lord says to do, and I'll share it a little bit later, but he said casting. Amen. He doesn't just say cast. It's not a one-time thing. I think you have to continue to do it all your life. You're forever casting all your cares upon the Lord. Why? Because he cares for you. I never seen a time in my life when folks were more bound up, including myself, with fear and worry and troubles and those things. And God doesn't want it that way. Amen? Because he said, I'll carry it. Just cast it over me. You know what? I don't know if you came today. You're all loaded up with cares. But you know, you can dump them right here. Amen. You just pretend that he's here in his the flesh. And you can dump it all right at his feet. You know what? That's what he's asking you to do. That's what he tells you in 1 Peter 5:7. Casting all your care upon him, because he cares for you. Amen. I'm pausing just a little bit because I want to find the mind of the Lord. Would that be all right? You know, today I hope you can stay till we get done, and till God's done. And we're going to make some announcements. We waited later because most of you are here now. And if you didn't get to see the announcement, Luke, we got an event coming up. Guess what's happening next week? What's happening, young people, on the 8th in Lawrenceburg? What's happening? I heard it back there. What's happening? We're going back to school. It's something we usually do here this time of year. We have a back-to-school event. And Gwen is going to take care of that this year. And we're going to have it on her farm. And we're looking forward to that. And I just want Gwen to come, and she's going to share a little bit of that. Now, we do have a sign-up sheet back there. If you're coming, put down your name. If I said I was going to let Gwen do this, so I'm going to let Gwen do it. Come on, Gwen.
Well, I was having a party for Aubrey and Bentley. They're going to be turning 13 and 14. So I told Kenny, you know, sometimes we go to the swimming pool and for sales or different stuff, but we could combine that with the back-to-school party, because we're going to have a water slide and a small pool and some horseback riding. And I remember when I grew up, my mom made lunch for I don't know how many people, and that's when you went to church on Sunday morning and Sunday night, and I don't know how many people would come to the house. After church, you'd stay till church and go back to church. And we've had some really good times with friends and family and just fellowship, and that's what I want to do too. Just if you have kids, bring them. If you don't, just come to fellowship. We're going to have food, and if you want to bring a appetizer, side dish, whatever, I think we're going to have maybe pizza and chicken strips. So if you want to bring something, you don't have to, but if you want to, you can. But little Peyton that comes on Wednesday, she was at the house the other day, and of course, you know, when they come to the house, they want to get a horse out. And I said, okay. And she's like, this has been on my bucket list for so long. And I'm like, really? And then little Leah, she comes on Wednesday sometime too, and she was at my house one day, and she said, this has always been my dream. I'm like, what? To ride a horse? And I'm like, well, your dream's coming true today. So it's just those little things I don't think some kids get to do, especially if they live in town. And we just decided to combine the party. No, don't bring any gifts. It's not a birthday party to bring gifts. It's just a party to fellowship with our church family and the kids and have a good time. That's all we're going to do.
Amen.
Kayla's going to give us a video here. Not a video, but I want you to listen to this song, and I'll tell you why.
There's a hole not an empty going on.
There's a whole lot of tears, a whole lot of fears. Somewhere along the way we've lost our soul. Let us stand on the rock of the ages. Let us shine like the city on the hill. There's a hole in the heart of America that only God can fill.
Played that this morning, a couple different reasons why. That was the Neyland's latest release, and it was supposed to went out. As far as I know, I guess they just released it, Marty, when yesterday or Saturday. The video, amen. But I want to get that album. Yeah, I don't know if I told you earlier, most of the group in this plane crash, seven of them, lost their lives. More than three families that will be affected for the rest of their lives. America's got trouble. Amen. But the church has trouble. Amen. I've got my own troubles. But you know what? I can't just scoot it under the rug and think about, hey, it'll get better one day. Well, it will if we change our hearts. If my people will humble themselves and pray and turn from the wicked ways and seek my face, that's when he'll heal our land. That's when there won't be a hole anymore in America. Now, America's got out. I promised that I would try to stay. I made a promise to me and God today I'd try to stay on track. So I put it on paper so I could stay on track. And if you're a children's church, they can be dismissed this morning if you like. And then I'm going to say a few things and we're going to get in the Word of God. How many love the Word of God? I said, how many love the Word of God?
Amen.
All right. You don't have to be loud to get it. But sometimes I just like to know that you're there. Now, old people have trouble hearing, don't they, Sean? Now, he's shaking his head, but he's a lot younger than me. But good to have him and his family here today. And we're just grateful that all of y'all are special. I'm just thinking, as they're leaving, I want to talk just a little bit about the heart motives of God. And this is what I feel they are. And I just want to follow what Jesus followed. You know what I mean? I believe Jesus had a heart motive. And I think sometimes we get it all figured out. We got it so good that we don't even understand what we're really, why we're doing this. But, you know, recently I had to just question, why am I doing this? Why do I do this? And sometimes you just have to do that in life and kind of reconnect and recollect and make sure everything is where it ought to be. You see, there's a time and there's a place. The Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes for all of it. I want to know that I'm right in the center where I feel like God wants me at. You need to know that. There's a lot of peace in that. If you don't, a lot of people are never at peace where they're at. They're always looking for something else. But God places you right in a spot. That's a good place for you to work. Amen. I don't have to go looking for a yard to mow when I got one to mow my own yard. Yeah, anybody wants to? No, it's okay right now. We had to mow for a long time. But I love you this morning. But I want to say a couple things to you, and then I'm going to get right into the Word of God. Our hearts have been heavy. We came out here to get some stuff put on the overhead and different things last night, and we just went. But everything's good. You know why? Because I believe God bottles every tear that you have. He knows everything you're up against. He knows when it's good. He knows when it's bad. I love real people, so does God. Amen. The heart motive of Christ, number one, was to bring glory and honor to the Father. The second heart motive was to love people. Amen. Now, he loves people, good and bad. You know why? Because he created all those people. Now, the third motive is to hate evil. You know, now the world's mixed up. The culture's mixed up. So they think they ought to hate people that love God. No, you ought to hate evil. Always love people. All lives matter. All lives matter. God loves his people. That was what Jesus' plan was. And I'm gonna show you in the Word of God. Now grab your, who's got your Bible with you this morning? Any Bibles in the house? All right. Now, I'm going to try to help you a little bit and not be too stupid. All right? Somebody used to tell me that you can't do anything for stupid. Oh, yeah, you can get them saved, glory to God. And God help them. Amen. Hold your word up this morning. Say this with me. Amen. This is the Word of God. Let it change me. Rearrange me. And make me more like Jesus. All right, I want you to flip over in your Bible this morning, and then we'll look at this first passage, and I'm going to try to get right into this message, not keep you too long. Amen. This first passage comes from Romans, the 5th chapter, the 7th and the 8th verse. Amen. Why Jesus? Amen. Paul wrote this passage, but he was telling the church at Rome, here's what he told them. But God commendeth his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. He loved you that much that he was willing to die for you. Have you ever felt like something was leading you or guiding you? I feel it more and more all the time. I feel like the Lord leads and guides, and you have to be sensitive to that. we say it around the church, kind of churchy. We say opening and closing doors. How many's ever heard that? God's opened a door, he's closed the door. These things, we say that. But there's times when I've been set up before. When I was, it's been a long time ago. I've had a lot of practice. But when I turned 50, who laughed? I think it was a guy back there who's a lot older than I am. But anyway, but 50, I turned 50, and I was surprised. My children told me a 50th birthday party. And I still got the shirt. But anyway, no, I'm just kidding you this morning. But I was set up that day because I didn't really know what was going on. All of a sudden, we had a 50th birthday party, and I was surprised. Sometimes you get set up, and you don't realize it's coming, and you get shocked about what happens. And I want to look at a place in the Bible today. It comes from the John, the 4th chapter, if you would turn there with me today. And I'm going to read this morning. You can follow along if you want to, but I'm going to read it. I felt like it would just speak to us better if I could read it right out of the Message paraphrase. It's not a Bible, it's a paraphrase, and I just want to read it to you this morning. And if I was going to title this message anything, I'd say, God will set you up. God will set you up. And I got a finish to that title. That's just half of it. But we're going to look at, if you go with me now to John, the 4th chapter. If you're on your cell phone, this is a message, paraphrase, translation, however you want to say it. But we'll start out at verse 1. Jesus realized that the Pharisees were keeping count of his baptism that he and John had performed. Although his disciples, not Jesus, did not have actual baptizing, they had posted the score that Jesus was ahead in turning him and John into revivals in the eyes of the people, so that Jesus left the Judean countryside and went back to Galilee. That's verse 3 verses. Now, let me tell you this morning, I want to talk to you a little bit about it because I'm going to comment it as I go through. I don't have this in my notes. I have the scripture here. I'm going to read the scripture, and I'm just going to allow the Word of God and the Holy Spirit to speak to me today and what to say. I've been over it several times, and sometimes I wish I could get this quiet. There it goes. Amen. Anybody got a concrete block? Somebody say, help him, Jesus. All right. Now, aren't we like that sometimes? We try to figure out who's doing all the baptism. You know, who's doing what? What's the preacher doing? What are they doing down on Main Street? What are they doing out here? Or what are they doing on the other end of town? You know what? All that is labels, and one day all of that will fly off. And when Jesus looks at us, or God looks at us one thing, he's going to want to know one thing. What did you do with my son, Jesus? Did you live for him? Did you work for him? Did you know him? Did you know my son? He won't be looking for my titles, electrician. He won't be looking for factory worker, secretary, all those labels. He won't be looking for Sunday school teacher or bus driver or song leader or pastor. He won't be looking for that. He's going to look for one thing. He's going to glance over in the book. He already knows. But he's going to see if my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And he's going to look and see if the blood of Jesus has been applied to my life. Yeah. Amen. That's what I want to do one day. I want him to see that the blood of Jesus has been applied to my life. Now, Jesus was in a circumstance here. You know what? He was going to get out of here. Things wasn't right here. The best way to do it, I'm going to go back to Galilee. And the only way he could get there, we'll read it in verse 4. So Jesus left the Judean countryside and went back to Galilee. Everybody say Galilee. Galilee. To pass through Samaria. Verse 5, he came to Sychar, its Samaritan village that bordered the field Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Verse 6, Jacob's well was still there. Jesus, worn out by the trip. How many's ever been worn out by the trip? Sometimes I've been worn out by the trip. I called a nephew of mine. God laid him on my heart. And I feel like he was just weary. And I was just wanting to know how I can encourage him. And I wasn't going to call him at all. And then some scripture come to my mind. And have you ever been out? I've been worn out by the trip. And Jesus was worn out by the trip. You know, he didn't climb on a bus. They went everywhere by foot. Amen. They took long walks, dusty mountainous country, all types of terrain. And he's wore out. And think about it. When you get wore out, you get what? Thirsty. Amen. America's got a whole wide, but they're thirsty and they don't even realize it. Amen. It just kind of sneaks up on you like the drought has snuck up on us. Things are so dry. The ground is all dried up. But friend, I'm going to tell you that the church is dried up. The church is dried up. Come on, let's don't make it something. Let's don't call it something it ain't. America's dried up, and we need to get back to the right place. But I tell you where we can find it at, the same place. It's getting ready. There's a miracle getting ready to happen here, and I want to read it to you, and we're going to talk about it. Amen. Look at Jesus was worn out by the trip. He sat down at the well. Have you ever done that? Ooh, I can't go no more. I'm just going to sit down here till I get straightened up, till somebody brings me a drink of water, till something changes in my life. I've done that. But what does he say? What we sung this morning. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They'll mount up with wings as eagles. They'll run and not be weary. They'll walk and not faint. Now, when you look across America, if you're looking for a man, if you're looking a man to see how many is baptized, if you're looking for a man to see how many votes he got in a state, if you're looking for a preacher to lead you out, I'm glad there are men of God that are living for God and are standing for God. I made a stupid thought not long ago. I thought, Lord, is there anybody standing for you in America? Is there anybody using the platform that they have to lift you up and to call America back to God? Well, I'm here to tell you there still are. There's not enough. Amen. There's not enough people in the congregation. There's not enough people in Lawrenceburg to stand up. I don't care how much scripture you know. You can quote it till you're blue in the face, friend, but if you ain't living it and you ain't walking it, what good is it doing you this morning? I'll just have to ask you that. If it hasn't moved you out of the seat, how good has it done you today? If it hadn't brought you up on your feet, you see, Jesus sat down for a minute, but it's fixing to bring him back up because there's work to do, and there's work to do here in this city. There's work to do at your workplace. This is our mission field. Your workplace is your mission field. Lawrenceburg is my mission field. Wherever God calls me, it's my mission field. Why? Well, I'm not here just to go through and live a happy, blessed life, which that comes from living from God. I'm glad that I can have it. Look at it. He sat down at the well. It was noon. You ever sat down in the hot of the day? Right now, you go out there and sit down about 90. I was cutting up with my niece. I said, well, you want to go outside? She come down to visit this weekend. She said, well, no. She said, I'm allergic to outside. I said, you and about another 2.5 million children in the world are allergic to outside. Not everybody's that way, but we were different back in. Mama kicked us out of the house, and she said, I'll let you back in at supper time. But it's different now. And come on, we're running after, you know, be careful. Watch about your kids. Make sure they know God. Make sure they're living for God. Come on, I don't care if they got a phone or not. It don't matter to me. But if it's hindering them from knowing God, if it's hindering them from being social, if it's messing up their life, there's good things, friend. There was good things and bad things when I was back there in the day. But I'm going to tell you what, you better grab the good things. And when you see your child grabbing hold of something that ain't good, you need to speak into their life. I saw one, I'm getting off here a little bit. But I saw one the other day, he just needed a good old barnyard burning. What am I talking about? He needed to go out behind the barn and wear his little tail out. But he wasn't mine, and that wasn't my lane. Well, I thought I was going to have to fight Marty to keep her from doing it, but no, I'm just kidding you. Let's go back to the scripture here. It was noonday. A woman, A Samaritan woman came to draw water. Jesus said, would you give me a drink? Would you give me a drink of water? Now, I got to get it down in your heads this morning. He wanted a drink of water. You know why? Because he was thirsty. But that wasn't the only reason he was there that day. You know what? Look at it. The disciples had gone into town to get some lunch. His disciples had gone to buy lunch. But Jesus has got some work to do here. The Samaritan woman taken back. How come you, a Jew, are asking me, a Samaritan woman, for a drink? She was blown away because Jews normally didn't speak to the Samaritans. You know what? We're kind of like it too. We'll see somebody walking down the street. We won't, we go over on the other side. Why? Because I owed him $10. You know what I'm talking about. Well, you don't know what you remember what she said to me last time we was together? Come on now. What Jesus said, one of the motives is love people. Love people. Sometimes you just got to say I'm sorry and just keep on moving. Jesus just simply said, can you give me a drink? And look at her reply. Amen. Jews in those days, in parentheses, it says Jews in those days weren't caught dead talking to Samaritans. Jesus answered, if you knew the generosity of God and who I am, you wouldn't be asking me for a drink. Now, isn't it wild how he witnesses to this woman? Isn't it wild how he's getting ready to share who he is? He said, and I would give you a fresh living water. Amen. Now, you don't get it, do you? Well, it's good today I brought my bucket. And the reason I brought my bucket, because I know how people are. I sit right up here so I don't go to sleep. You know what? She's fixing to tell him, sir, but you don't have a bucket. Let's look at it here. What did he say? Jesus answered, if you only knew Jesus, you know I could give you a drink of fresh water. Sir, you don't even have a bucket to draw with, and the well is deep. She didn't know how deep the well really was. Let's go on. So how are you going to get this water? Are you a better man than your ancestor Jacob, who dug this well and drank from it? He and his sons and livestock, and it passed down to us. Come on, don't we get like that sometimes? We're telling about all the stuff that happened in the past. That's what she's doing. Do you remember in 1974 when we got to save? Don't you remember when the church was Fort Bill? Don't you remember the revival that hit the land? Friend, I was good back then, but it ain't what we're living on today. We got to live on something that's fresh today. We need a fresh drink of water, glory to God. We need a new revival right now. We need a heart change right now. I can't live on what happened to me in 1974. I got to have a new drink. You know why? Because Pastor Mark says it. Our buckets has got holes in them. You say, well, you don't have to get loud. Well, I'm sorry. Now, I ain't like pastor. If you come to hear pastor, I ain't the pastor. If you come to hear me next week, I won't be here preaching. Pastor will. He preaches one way, I preach another. You preach one way, and I'll preach another. But I hope you can get something from me today. I hope you can go home with the Word of God. Don't listen to a thing that I say, but go with what Jesus said. What he said? Jesus said, everyone who drinks this water will get thirsty again. And friend, you can have a bucket full, and it'll run out on you. And you can drink it all you want, but you're going to have a thirst. You're still going to be thirsty come tomorrow. After the long trip, you're still going to be thirsty again. Again and again, you'll be thirsty. But look at 14. I want to talk to you about it. Anyone I give will be an artesian spring within, gushing fountains of endless life. Can you talk about my Jesus and the living water that he can supply? Look at verse 15. The woman said, sir, give me this water. He's finally got her attention. Glory to water. I'm not talking about a bucket that's empty. Bucket with just some H2O in it. I'm talking about something that come out of Walmart in a 24-pack. I'm not about talking about something that come out of a spring somewhere. I'm talking about living water Jesus is talking about.
Yeah. Amen.
The woman said, I like it when it gets down to the good stuff. The woman said, sir, give me the Give me this water so I never get thirsty. Is anybody in the house thirsty? I'm just thirsty for more of my Lord and more of my Jesus, for more of His direction. Well, don't you have a regular life? Yeah, but it's just going to be over here in a little while. So you know what? I'm working on a life that's going to last Sister Charlotte for many years. I'm looking for some days when I won't have to worry about the days. I won't have to look at the clock. I won't have to wonder if I'm going to get done. I won't have to wonder if they're going to get mad at me if I preach too long. I won't have to wonder if there's mud on the floor. I won't have to wonder if the bus is going to run. I won't have to wonder, amen, if you like it or you don't like it. Amen. If you're looking for something, me, you're going to come up empty. Your bucket is going to be flat empty if you're looking for me. If you're looking for something from me. But I know a man that can give you a drink. And your bucket will run over. Your bucket will run over. And it's a vast supply. Let me go. You won't get thirsty. You won't ever come back to the well again. It's a one-time deal. I mess up. My hole get, but boy, I tell you what, He'll keep it running in so fast I can't even contain it. Amen. He is able to do exceedingly above all I can ask. My God's able to take care of me. He's able to take care of you, whether this country gets better or whether it don't. He's able to take care of you whether you got a job or whether you don't. Now, come on, do you ever have anybody ever read your mail? You ever get the wrong thing in the mail? I have. Goes down the street. I hate it when it comes and it has to be on the other end of Bond Lane. That means I got to go all the way out, come up here and go all the way down to Harry Wise and go over the other end to deliver it. I just can't walk down the street. But this woman is getting ready to get her mail read. Look at her. Verse 16. He said, go call your husband and then come back. Well, when Jesus gets in your stuff, He's in your stuff. Look what she said. I have no husband, she said. That's nicely put. I have no husband. Jesus, come on, He's telling her how it goes. Verse 18, you've had five husbands, and the man you're living with now isn't even your husband. You spoke the truth there, sure enough. Now, the paraphrase kind of gets down into where we talk and where we live. That's why I read it this morning. Look at verse 19. When you finally get in, somebody gets in your mail, you finally had to just come clean. And she's going to come clean right here. Oh, so you're a prophet. Now, when somebody gets in your case and they start really pointing it out, you know what you do? You try to change the subject. When somebody really gets in your stuff, all you try to do is just change it. Say, oh, I don't want to go there. Let's don't talk about marriage and divorce. Let's don't talk about living for God. Let's don't talk about how good a worshiper you are. Let's don't talk about how much you put in the offering. None of that matters. We just try to change the subject. But what Jesus, he puts her right back on track. Look at verse 20. What she says, well, tell me this. Our ancestors worshiped God at this mountain, but the Jews insist Jerusalem is the only place for us to worship right now. Verse 21, believe me, woman. Come on now. Now, listen, you want to get in, you get in a conversation with Jesus, you ain't never going to win, I can tell you that. Maybe in your prayer life you try to get in a conversation with Him, but I'm going to tell you, He's going to come out on top. Look at 21. Believe me, woman, the time is coming when Samaritans will worship. When you Samaritans will worship the Father neither here in these mountains or there in Jerusalem, you'll worship guessing in the dark. We Jews are in the clear light of day. God's way of salvation is made available through the Jews. Come on, He was telling her, listen, it's going to come. The Jews are God's chosen people. If you're going to know anything, you're going to know it through God's chosen people. And if you want to find something out, you find you a real man of God. Amen? And if He can't tell you, then you go to the source, friend. Go to the source for and talk to God, and you'll get the truth. Listen what it is. I'm going to go on through here. There's a lot more in there, but I won't share that. It's not necessary this morning what we want to try to accomplish. Look at verse 23. But the time is coming, And it has, in fact, come when what you're called will not matter where you go to worship. It doesn't matter where you worship. It doesn't matter. I got to put my bucket up here. Listen, it doesn't matter where you worship. It don't matter if you worship down on Main Street. It doesn't matter if you worship out here on the right or if you go all the way to the other, other end of town. It doesn't matter. It matters that you worship Him in spirit and truth. That's what the Word's going to tell us. Skip our labels. When we go to heaven, we won't have a label. When I stand before God, I won't have a label. I'm going to be the redeemed. I'm going to be a child of God. You're going to be a child of God. Now listen to what it says here. Come on, he brings her back on track here. Listen. And pick it back up at 23. But the time is coming, and has in fact come, when what you were called will not matter, and where you go to worship will not matter. It's who you are and the way you live that count before God. I'm not your judge. I didn't come to be your judge today. The Bible tells me not to judge. I got to read it again. It's who you are and the way you live that count before God. I'd like for all people to live for God. But it's not for me to call you. That's your lane. God deals with us individually, how you live and how you walk. But I'm going to tell you what, why in the world would you go around thirsty? Why would you go around dried out when my God's got a bucket that never runs dry? It's who you are and the way you live that count before God. Your worship, come on, must engage your spirit in the pursuit of truth. That's the kind of people the Father is looking for. Those who are simply, honestly, themselves. That's what I call real people. That's what I call real people. People that are just themselves. I love this church for that reason. Because they're real people. I don't know, maybe you got me fooled, but I don't know people in this church come here trying to put on something when they ain't. They are who they are. And they're just like me. They're sinners. But God commended, God showed His love to us by giving His Son on a cruel old cross for you and me. That's the kind of people the Father's looking for, those who simply, honestly themselves before Him in their worship. Verse 24, God is sure being Himself, Spirit. Those who worship Him, the King James says, they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and truth. I got meters and stuff that I use. It just tells the truth. You know, you go over and stick your finger in that wall plug over there and you're going to know it's got voltage in it. Now, if you need to know exactly how many volts it is, you got to put a meter on it. And one day, God's going to put a meter on all of us. And I don't know where you'll stand. Will you stand like this woman? Come on, let's read on the story. It gets better. Amen. Verse 25. The woman said, I don't know about that. See, you don't have to know it all to get right, do you? You don't have to know every scripture in the Bible. All you got to do is just come just like you are. Just come just like you are. The woman said, I don't know about that. I do know that the Messiah is coming. When He arrives, we'll get the whole story. I love His reply right here, verse 26. I am He. Jesus said, this is Him. I'm the Messiah. That's who you're talking to right now. I am He, said Jesus. You don't have to wait any longer or look any further. Just then, His disciples came back. Amen. Ain't that the way the devil works? Just about time things is getting good. It happens on Wednesday night. It happens on Sunday morning. It happens when you're witness at work. Amen. Here Jesus is right in the top. Boy, He's got down to the good stuff. You're talking to the Messiah. You're talking to the Savior of the world. And look how it is, just like the church is. Look what it says, verse 27. Then the disciples came back. They were shocked. They couldn't believe that He was talking to that kind of a woman. No one said what they were thinking about. Have you ever been there? But their faces showed. Look at verse 28. You know when somebody really gets saved because there's been a transformation. 28, the woman took the hint and left. How many people have left when the church looked at them the wrong way because they didn't have on the right kind of dress or the right kind of pants or they had earrings on or all that stuff that we hang on, folks. What's God looking for? He's looking for real people that'll be honest. And when He reads their mail, they will just say, yeah, I need Jesus. Let's go on. The woman took the hint. In her confusion, she left her water pot. She just got messed up. You know what I'm talking about? Jesus will mess you up. When you have a real divine encounter with God, it will mess you up. You'll come to get water. You'll bring your bucket. And she left, as far as I know, the way the Bible says, she left with no water. Friend, she left with an empty bucket sitting on the ground. But she had something that was even greater. Let's finish it here, and then I'm going to close. Verse 29. Let's read the rest of 28. The woman took the hint and left. In her confusion, she left her water pot. Back in the village, she told the people. Okay? When God does something for you, amen, you got to tell somebody. 29 says, come see a man who knew all the things I did, who knows me inside and out. Do you think this could be the Messiah? And they went out to see for themselves. I'm going to close right here. I'm going to ask my brother to come to the piano. I thank you for your patience today, but right now is probably the most important time. I'd ask nobody to be moving. Brother's going to come to the piano. Verse 29 said, come see a man. I make a cry to you today if you don't know him. If you came in with an empty bucket. If you came in with a bucket with a hole in it. If you don't know this Jesus, he can introduce you to a water where you'll never thirst again. It's a life. It's a life-giving fountain. Amen. Come see a man who knew all the things that I did. You see, he knows me inside and out. He knows you inside and out today. Do you think this could be the Messiah? Yes, it is. He's the only one that knows. He knows you inside and out. And you see, the road was the only road was the road that went through Samaria to get there. But Jesus had other plans, and He's got other plans for you today. And maybe you're right where that woman at the well where she was at. And if you don't know the real Messiah today, you can know him. And I'm going to make this simple. We've made it. We've made church real easy. I'm surprised we even come to this building. You know, I look for us one day, we'll just drive up to a gate and it'll pop out a little message and on the DVD, and we'll just drive through and make a round and going back and put our money in another pot and leave a note for somebody. Hi, sister so-and-so. You know what I mean? It's all got to be easy. But sometimes it just needs to be what it is. And today I'm going to open these altars. Amen. Pastor Mark gives us the opportunity every week to know the Lord. And if you're out there on the internet, I want you to know the Lord. This message is just for you and everybody else, anybody that can hear it and it can change their life. But there is a Messiah, the Christ. Amen. And He loves you today. And He paid a high price so that we could be saved and know the Lord in a real way, and our bucket could run over and we would never thirst. You can come boldly right now. I just thought the altars are open right now. If you need to know God and you feel like maybe your bucket's had a hole in it, if you feel like you don't even know the Lord, you feel like you need to get things right, or maybe you've been like me, you've been racing around the world, and man, you didn't realize that all your bucket water splashed out, and you just need a refilling today. Amen. The altars are open. Amen. I like what that little song says. I don't know if I know all the words. I'm going to watch Marty. Maybe if I don't get them, she'll tell me. Fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up. I lift it up, Lord. Come and feel the come and feel the thirsting of my soul. Come up and sing it with me. Bread of heaven, feed me till I won't know more. Here's my cup, I lift it up, make me whole. What's the second line? What is it? Fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. What's the third line? Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Amen. Amen. Let's do it again. Fill my cup, Lord. Lift it up. Sing it, church. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven. You don't like me telling you what to do, but I just want everybody in the congregation, come on, just come on to the altar. Come on, just all of us come. Come on, let's get a drink today. Let's get a drink. Let's come to the fountain. Amen. Sing it again, brother. We're going to do it again. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We love you, Lord. I pray that you would touch us today, God. Lord, that you would touch our lives, God. Fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, fill me till I want. Just seek the Lord. I want to talk to the internet just for a minute. Maybe you don't know the Lord. I want to pray a prayer. If you're out there, maybe I wish you were here on this building today. And more than anything, I hope you're in the presence of the Lord. Because I can't do that part. That's what He does. That's His lane. But He knows you today just like He knew this woman at the well. And He wants to love on you today. He wants to point you to Himself, the true Messiah. He wants you to be a true worshiper today. Amen. Say this, sing this, say this prayer with me. If you're in the room or you're out there, say, "Dear Lord, I need you. Come into my heart. Forgive me of my sins and my shortcomings. I believe you died on the cross for me. I believe you took my place. You carried the sin of the world. And you're the Savior of the world. Create in me a right heart. Renew a right spirit in me. In Jesus' name." And come and be a part of one of our services. We'd love to have you today. God bless you in Jesus' name.